Body Image, Today contributor and psychiatrist. Welcome back.
Thank you.
You know, you talk about a lot of different stories that are based on many different scenarios.
Correct.
But certainly so many women are, I sometimes think about the time women spend worrying about their weight and their bodies, and we could probably cure cancer.
I know.
You know what I mean? Why are so many of us, and I include myself in this category, frankly, plagued by a bad body image, constant worries about our weight and our appearance? Well, I can tell you why.
I can tell you why you think so, but, you know.
So much positive reinforcement based solely on your appearance and not that much based on what you you're about internally and some of your actions and character traits. You know, somebody loses weight and people go on and on about them.
And this happens in childhood.
About
how pretty. You're so pretty. You know, I mean, often we focus on, you're so cute, you're so pretty,
more for women than
more,
more
for
girls than boys. That's why I always say to my kids, you're so smart.
Exactly.
And I try not to emphasize
Or look what
that.
You did or you were able to do.
Or you were so kind.
Exactly. Exactly. You want to
say in terms of staving off eating disorders, you should never talk about dieting, your weight, if you're fat, but I guess it's hard to avoid because everybody does it.
You know what? You can.
But what about the images in popular culture?
Absolutely.
I mean, the models in fashion magazines, first of all, they're like 15 or 16 years old.
That's
they have
right.
no body fat.
They're pre-pubescent looking almost.
They're also airbrushed to death.
It's not real.
But yourself to those images.
But let me say that the people who compare themselves the most.
And they don't get out.
They don't get out. They stay in there like this little story. I mean, how many women do you know that will remember the boy who said something or the girl?
About some of the personality scenarios. Tell us about the self-defeater story, what she has heard in her past that continues to play in a tape in her head.
So as and in the child.
And this doesn't have to be something about your appearance or food. It could just be
negative. Absolutely. It could be just.
Then is they never look good enough.
Right.
I think almost all women fall in this category.
This is a very huge.
Right? If I only lost 10 more pounds, my life would be perfect.
Exactly. My life would be.
Affect your social life and love life.
It's so inhibiting. Completely inhibiting.
About how to get rid of it.
I know, again, easier said than done.
Using the word they and use the word I. Give me an example.
What I mean is.
In other words, is that what you mean?
Yes, exactly.
When it happens.
When it happens, and there you are.
You say, take new action. What do you mean by that?
I mean, that's worthy. And start saying the things that.
And gosh darn it, people like me.
And people like me.
So important because people are making themselves miserable for no good reason.
For no good reason. It's very sad, but they can change it.
Right.
If they really want to.
Okay, Gail, thanks so much. You can read an excerpt, by the way, from Becoming.